Hi, I'm Rachael Long, Farm Advisor with UC Cooperative Extension in the Sacramento Valley. And in this video, I'm going to share how to identify Lygus bugs, which are also known as the Western Tarnished Plant Bug. Lygus bugs are serious pests of many field crops. Lygus bugs feed by piercing plant tissue with beak-like mouthparts and injecting toxins that break down plant tissue. Their feeding damage causes bud, flower, and bowl drop in cotton, as well as seed distortions, stains, blank shells, and a loss in seed viability for planting seed stock, like sunflowers, and also in dry beans. Feeding on fruit and vegetables also causes distortions as well as rot. When left uncontrolled, Lygus can cause serious yield and crop quality losses. Adult Lygus bugs are yellowish brown, long and thin, about a quarter inch or 6 millimeters, with a distinctive yellowish V-shaped triangle on their back. They fly off quickly when disturbed. The yellow V marking helps identify Lygus from other insects such as calochorus bugs, which is a big pest of pistachios, as well as false chinch bugs or the beneficial big-eyed bug and damsel bugs that prey on crop pests. Lygus bugs lay eggs in plant tissue that are sealed outside by an oval-shaped cap. Lygus nymphs, the immature forms of Lygus, are light green and resemble aphids but lack cornicles or hind projections. They are also busy and move around quickly when disturbed, unlike aphids that are more sedentary and stay in one place. Older Lygus nymphs resemble adults in shape, but are more green and lack wings. The wings gradually appear with each molt. Lygus are spring and summertime pests, and they generally build up in weeds like this mustard shown here that surround the field edges. And when these weeds begin to dry down, the Lygus then move and disperse into adjacent crops. And Lygus can also build up in crops like alfalfa, also safflower. And when the alfalfa is cut or the safflower begins to dry down, then the Lygus will move into adjacent crops where they can cause significant damage. Be sure to monitor crops and weeds surrounding sensitive crops, especially when they are most vulnerable to Lygus damage. Lygus bugs are best monitored in field crops using a sweep net. Pay attention to the time of day because Lygus will hide in the plant canopy on hot days, making them difficult to sample. Thresholds for Lygus depends on the crop as well as the plant variety, with some plants having more tolerance or resistance to Lygus than others. Various naturally occurring beneficial insects attack Lygus bugs. These include the parasitoid wasp, anaphes, that preys on Lygus eggs, big-eyed bugs, damsel bugs, minute pirate bugs that prey on Lygus nymphs, and even spiders that prey on both Lygus nymphs and adults. So it's important to conserve beneficial insects because these natural enemies also help to control pests like aphids and mites that can be incredibly injurious to crops. So in controlling Lygus bugs, it's important to use soft insecticides that have minimal impacts to natural enemies. It's important to monitor for Lygus bugs. It's also important to control weedy vegetation around farms like mustard and radish that do attract Lygus bugs, that when they dry down, that they move into adjacent crops. And it's also really important to plant habitat around farms, including native California flowering plants like this buckwheat shown here, that provide nectar and pollen resources for natural enemies that then feed on these floral resources, and they will move into adjacent crops where they'll help to control a number of different types of crop pests, including Lygus bugs. For more information about Lygus bug management, thresholds, and sampling in your crop, visit the UCIPM Pest Management Guidelines.